Hello everybody, and welcome to Portland College's 2021 Carol Concert. You'll see, once again, we're joining you online rather than in person, as the pandemic shows no signs of letting go. But that won't dampen our celebrations or our Christmas spirit. I'm delighted to welcome Reverends Kate and Claire from our local Church of England, St. Peter's in Ravenshead, who will lead the service.
Hello everyone and welcome to your carol service. And unfortunately we're online again, or through the wonders of the camera, instead of being outside in your grounds. But it's great to be able to join with you in this way. And for any of you that don't know our names, I'm Reverend Claire.
I'm Reverend Kate.
And it's great to be able to share this with you now. Taken from the Bible, and it's the book of Luke, chapter 2, verses 1 to 7. The birth of Jesus. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
Amen.
So this next reading is taken from Luke chapter 2, verses 8 to 16. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favour rests." When the angels had left them and gone to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about."
Oh,
Our next reading is from Matthew chapter 2. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea during the time of King Herod, kings from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Christ was to be born. "In Bethlehem, in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. You, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will be the shepherd of my people Israel." Then Herod called the king secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and make a careful search for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold and of incense and of myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route.
Well, I wonder what your favourite thing about Christmas is. Maybe have a think about that for a moment inside your head. And you have a think as well, Kate? Maybe you want to share something, Kate, about what your favourite thing is about Christmas.
There are lots of things I love about Christmas. I love the music and the food, but I think probably the most favourite thing is seeing people and playing games and having lots of free time with friends and family.
Oh, thank you. And I'm sure you've all thought of things that you like for Christmas as well. I know one of the things that lots of people get excited about are gifts and presents. And I was thinking why we give gifts. And we give gifts because we want to show people that we love and care for them, don't we? And I've got a couple of gifts here. And I'm going to see if you or Kate can guess what they are.
Ooh, exciting.
Just show it to the camera first.
Okay.
Maybe you're thinking about what it might be, but Kate, you have a look and a feel. I wonder if you can guess what it is.
I think, shall I say my guess?
Yeah, go on.
Yeah? I think it might be a ball.
Ooh, well, let's open it and
shall
have
I
a
open
look.
It? Yeah. Exciting.
Opening the presents is always quite good fun too. Now, if you like balls and footballs, that would be a very exciting present to receive,
yeah,
wouldn't
that's
it?
Great.
So, a ball, please. Tell what that was.
More or less
I could tell, yeah.
A present for you here.
Oh.
I wonder if anyone can think what that might be.
Well, it's got a very familiar shape, and it feels as though it might be a cup,
a plastic. I think it's made of plastic. A plastic cup.
I think that's what it is.
Nice,
it's
not, isn't it? Open it up then and have a look. See if that is. I should tell you to try and keep it as upright as you can.
Oh, yeah. Why is that then? I want.
Wow! It is a plastic cup, but look what's inside. It's full of treasure.
Full of treasure. Chocolate coins. Or maybe gold coins, but no, chocolate coins.
I'm hoping they're chocolate.
Treasure.
That's fab. Wow. Well, sometimes we do know immediately what we've been given, don't we? But sometimes it's harder to work it out. And we even get gifts that aren't what they first seem on the outside. For example, this cup looked plain and ordinary, or it felt plain and ordinary when Kate was feeling it. But inside there was that chocolate treasure.
Well, I'd like to tell you about the most amazing gift ever. And for me, that's Jesus. And we think about Jesus at Christmas time, don't we? And Jesus is Emmanuel. And Emmanuel means God with us. Now, God came down as a little baby and was that first Christmas gift. But like the cup with the chocolate in, he wasn't exactly what we expected. On first sight, he would have just been an ordinary human baby. But actually, he was lots more than that. He was and is a treasure worth more than we can possibly imagine. I believe that Jesus is the light of the world and that he can shine in the darkest of times and help us through troubled times. He was a gift that meant we could also be brought closer to God. And through Jesus, God could show us how much he loves us. So perhaps this Christmas, when you're opening your gifts, you might like to take time to remember what Christians believe. That Jesus is the most amazing gift ever given.
Okay, well, we're nearly at the end of our service, but we're going to say a prayer before we finish. And actually, I'm going to use one of those chocolate coins that Claire had for my prayer. So imagine you've got a chocolate coin, and maybe next time you do actually have one, you could remember this prayer and say it yourself, use it again to say a prayer. So think about the chocolate coin. Think about how bright and shiny and gold it is on the outside and how it shines the light and how it can remind us of all the good things that we enjoy. Maybe you're looking forward to some lovely times at Christmas. Maybe there's some lovely things that you're enjoying now. And as you think about the shiny gold outside of the coin, just quietly in your heart, say thank you to God for the good things in your life. And then if you feel the outside of a coin, you'll know that sometimes it feels a bit rough, doesn't it, around the outside? There are little markings that make it rough. And as it starts to get opened, the foil can be a bit scratchy on your fingers. And so we want to remember that actually some people are having a bit of a tough time at the moment. For some people, they might not be looking forward to Christmas, or there might be some difficult things happening in their lives. It might be you, might be someone else that you know. And some people are sleeping rough. They don't have a home to call their own. So let's just remember those people in our hearts and ask God to help them. And then can you imagine peeling off the wrapper on your chocolate coin and tasting it? Now, I'm not going to taste it now, otherwise I won't be able to talk anymore. But in a minute, I will taste my coin. And we think about that lovely, sweet, yummy flavour of chocolate in our mouths. And I'm going to think about something that we'd like God to make better in the world, something that we want him to do. And let's just mention those things in our hearts now. So to finish our prayer, we're going to send all those different thoughts that we've had up to God. And we're going to do a curly-whirly Amen. Now, I need to step back from the camera a bit for that. But you start down low, you roll your hands and you say Amen. Get louder and louder and louder and then send it up to God. But we'll go and do that from a bit further away so you can see us. So start down low. Amen. That was a good practice. Let's do it one more time for real. Amen.
And I think we've come towards the end of the carol service now. So we'd like to wish you all a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
and we hope to see you again soon.
Happy Christmas.
We wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Good tidings we bring to you and your kin. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We all want some figgy pudding, we all want some figgy pudding, we all want some figgy pudding, so bring some out here. Good tidings we bring to you and your kin. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We won't go until we've got some. We won't go until we got some. We won't go until we got some. So bring some out here. Good tidings we bring to you and your kin. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Welcome to my Christmas song. I'd like to thank you for
Well, that was marvellous. Thank you so much to Reverends Kate and Claire for leading our celebration, and to the learners, citizens and staff of Portland College who took part and created the wonderful music, and particularly our hard-pressed marketing team who put this video together and brought us our online celebration. All it remains for me to do is wish you all a very happy Christmas, peaceful and prosperous New Year as we look forward to 2022.